Hi, I'm Dr. Robert Hedaya, and I'd like to talk to you about something that is not actually talked about much in psychiatry, and that's your gut. Most of the people who come in to see a psychiatrist have gastrointestinal problems. They may have reflux, they may have constipation, diarrhea, belching, bloating, gassiness. It's very, very common. I would say about 90% of my patients have it, and I think it's been well established in the literature that that's the case for most psychiatrists. Irritable bowel syndrome, well known to be associated with any psychiatric problem. Most of the time, if a psychiatrist sees these problems when they take their history, they will send someone to a gastroenterologist, and I'm sorry to say that most of the time they will have endoscopy or colonoscopy, which may be appropriate, and they'll end up on medication. I think oftentimes that's not necessary. So what we do is we take that thorough history and then we look at diet, we look at nutritional factors, we look at enzymes, we look at bacteria, we rule out parasites, excessive yeast. All of these things have to be addressed. And then, hard to believe that 90 or 95% of my patients actually have complete clearance of their gut problems. Now, why is that an issue for me as a psychiatrist? Because when the gut is activated, it affects the brain. This is well established. The immune system is activated, and that changes your brain chemistry. So it is incumbent upon psychiatrists to treat these problems, unless it's clearly outside of their realm and needs direct care by a gastroenterologist. But in general, these problems are readily treated by a psychiatrist with simple methods. I encourage you to look into these issues for yourself.